All right, let's go.
Remember how in many cases, people were constantly attacked and sometimes even lynched simply because they did not want to obey the irrational official version, and they did not want to obey because they knew the dangerous invisible predator was found in the supposed cure and not in a free state and in the air. So the awakened minority was also under tremendous pressure, and also in a pure survival state, as they too felt that their integrity was under attack. With this situation, two groups of people were placed one against the other, neither one being able to comply with the demands of the other. But one group, the one that followed the official version, was vastly superior in numbers and forces over the awakened, highly conscious minority. Now, replace the invisible little monster that caused everyone to live in fear during the past few years with extraterrestrials, an official disclosure where governments openly accept that extraterrestrials exist, and with a false alien invasion. None of those government agendas ever bring anything positive to the general population. The governments will tell the public only what they want the people to think, and it won't be the truth, because they never tell the truth to the people. After all, the truth is power, and they want the people powerless. As the ex-CIA director William Casey said, quote, "When everything the public knows is a lie, then we have succeeded." Never forget his words. Nai'Shara's theory, in my words. So, governments go about disclosing that they know that extraterrestrials exist, and they accept that they have been in contact with this or that other extraterrestrial group, they declassify documents and photographs about them, and they cook up an official narrative, as usual. So okay, they declassify and everything. And then it turns out that laws have to be imposed so that it doesn't get out of control. Depending on their narrative, new rules and restrictions must be imposed on the population, and new censorship criteria will also be developed, where it will be prohibited to talk about extraterrestrials in an open way, and whenever it is acceptable, only the official narrative must be said and shared.
Okay, oh my God. They don't even have to say that the aliens are invading or even a threat. They don't have to say that. They just, if this scenario, it would be like, my understanding of it so far is that, okay, they're going to start sharing information, disclosure. You want disclosure? We'll give you disclosure. And they just start making public access to a lot of the ET or alien information that they have, photographs and stories. They're going to spin a story, and it may not be like evil alien or bad alien or we're going to attack you alien, not like that, but just like aliens. And knowing human psychology, a lot of humans, especially the unawakened masses, are going to be thinking it themselves. Well, what if they're bad? What if they're not really good after all? What if they're planning something and our government doesn't even know it? Shouldn't the government do something about it? People might start thinking that way without the government having to say that they're evil or bad or a threat. So now spring up here and spring up there, pops up talking heads here and there and on social platforms that the cabal would be in control of with their bots, their chat bots, and get a lot of dialogue of the government and the official line isn't, this is just a theory, right? But they're not saying that the aliens are evil or bad. They're just saying, okay, you want disclosure? Yeah, they're out there. And now the government can sit back as an official position and go, what? We gave it to you, what? Now all these social platforms start popping up everywhere, and you know there's a lot of control of that. So all these dialogues go special interests and this group and that group, talking heads. Now they start getting a fan base, or they stir up the fear that a lot of humans will already have, and worries and concerns, and start do this fear-mongering that is not the official governmental world governments. It's not their official position. It happened out there on the internet, you know, cyberspace. It's like just people are getting all excited and demanding that we do something about this. We don't really see a threat, but okay. Okay, well, I guess we should look into this. Okay, we'll put in a few guidelines. We'll call them laws yet. We'll just call them guidelines on behavior and let that escalate over, what, a couple of weeks, a month, years? But let that escalate, and they could, the government and the cabal could start putting in restrictions, like just mentioned, without ever saying that there was an alien invasion. They could let the masses start spreading the rumor or the fear of an alien invasion. Wouldn't that be clever? The government doesn't. What if that's it? The government's not saying alien invasion. No, no, no. They're letting the people, you know, the people, right? The controlled opposition first get all worried and concerned and like, well, shouldn't we do something about it? Shouldn't the government? What? How's the Space Force coming along? Should we throw more money at the Space Force? Yeah, we probably should. Yeah, blah, blah, blah. And then, we should probably stop talking about the subject and giving away our position and stuff. And I could see how they could gradually start doing exactly what Nai'Shara and Mari are saying. Start putting in restrictions. So the same way I was unable to talk about certain subjects on the internet or in YouTube, I'd stop. What if they built it up? And it's not like even official. It's just like YouTube, for example, could decide that no, it's not good. It's not good and not healthy for the community of YouTube users to talk about certain subjects. They already got those bullet points. Are you talking about this? Are you talking about that? You got a bullet point and you got to check it off if you're talking about that. And they could have another one. Now, are you talking about ETs, UFOs, aliens, evil aliens? Who knows what they could do, but they could do it. I'm just going, wow. Very thought-provoking here.
They will say or may say that those restrictions are for the public's protection, as there are too many dangerous theories about the extraterrestrials circulating on the web and in the media, and censorship must be imposed supposedly also to protect the interests of those extraterrestrials, because planet Earth's visitors must be welcomed. Talking bad about them will be considered abusive, not inclusive, and so on. And in the case where the official version is not in favor of the extraterrestrials, or where they are presented as an invasive force of any kind, the governments will, or may, impose restrictions, ostracize and even persecute anyone who has openly spoken about this subject, specifically starseeds.
Wow. They're intelligent. You guys sure are smart people. I gotta give you that. Because I hadn't thought of it that way. I mean, the second part, yeah-ish. No, not even the second part. No, I was thinking about the government. This is like, you know, shallow thinking, right? Oh, yeah, false alien invasion, the cabal pushing this agenda, false alien invasion. No, it can go way deeper than that. But underneath it all, there's the whole thing about the aliens. And, oh, man. Thanks for the eye-opening info.
And people who have stated that they are extraterrestrials themselves, or who have said that they had, or have any type of contact with extraterrestrials, will or may be openly persecuted and attacked.
Oh shit. That would be me. Yeah, I could see how they would want to play a game like this. And what's to know about things like this? You know, this is just possibilities, speculation, theoretical what if, I don't know if they've got, you know, it's just like, hey, this is something they could be planning. We're not sure what they're planning. What if? But this what if this timelines, those things are playing out in alternate realities. So those realities do exist, just like the reality on a different timeline. California sank with a giant earthquake, you know, 20, 30 years ago in some alternate reality that you personally did not choose to go down. Sort of like, God, this is deep shit. And I see already the value I see in understanding this information is so that I can see the possible scenarios of how this could play out. And I can choose from here at my decision point, well, I'm not walking that path. I ain't going that way. And I'm not taking all of humanity with me. Because when I take one of these paths, I am taking everybody with me. I am recreating everything from that God source point of consciousness, pretending to be the point of consciousness here as an individual. And I'm seeing everything go run around, everybody doing everything, and it plays out like this, and the government's doing that, and these guys, ETs are doing that, and oh my God, I'm creating it all, and I'm taking you with me, and everybody else with me, along my personal journey, so to speak, in experience. But you're doing the same thing. And if you take a different line than I will, you see a different future. You're afraid of something, or you think this is going to happen, and you think it and feel it enough, you will manifest it, or you could choose that track instead of this track. So you are going this, and you're manifesting this track, and you're playing it out. It's your reality, and it does exist, and it is real for you. But this primary me here, I'm over here, I'm doing this. I go, nah, that's not me. I'm not living that reality, and I'm not living that time track. Not from this point of consciousness as my central point of original creation here. Kind of like that. It gets beyond explanation in words, for sure. But wow. So the value I see in information like this is it gives us the ability to go, no, not going there. I'm not doing it, and I'm going to share with my friends. It will help me support my own belief systems of, hey, if I tell enough people, or if enough people wake up on planet Earth soon enough, they won't buy it, and I won't buy it. And what you're really saying is, like, the greater super you isn't buying it as all the people. So you're creating your new reality and your backdrop people. You're creating it the way you would prefer it, by focusing on thinking about and manifesting and believing and agreeing, considering it into existence, that your preferred track. Kind of like that, but deep, probably much deeper. Yeah? Okay.
Both by government organizations and as a violent fear response reaction of the general population. There is no need for an open hostile alien invasion narrative to be presented to the public. Yeah. Declassification is all that is needed to start all this madness, because they will claim that they need to control the public's perceptions and reactions to this new information.
Oh man, that's brilliant. It'd take a genius. Well, from my perspective, it's going to take a genius to even understand the scenario, to present it to us and share this with us right now. But yeah. I can totally see now how Stephen Greer could be the controlled opposition from the get-go, from like 10, 15, 20 years ago, that work in this disclosure project, the whole entire disclosure project could be the plan and the strategy of how the cabal could put new restrictions on everyone and all of society all over the planet. So that's It doesn't have to be a false alien invasion or an alien invasion threat in your face. It's more like, hey, there's good guy aliens, and this is for their protection because there's a lot of hostile humans out there, and we got to control the narrative so that we're not bad-mouthing some friendly ETs and piss them off or alienate them. So we got to put these restrictions in so you stop bad-mouthing ETs. So that would be one clever trick. And the other clever trick would be, if there are bad boys out there, we're going to have to... So they can play both angles, you know. If there's just good guy ETs, or if there's good guys and bad guy ETs out there, they can, the cabal can play both angles, and either way start putting in restrictions on humanity. Wow. So in that way, I'm repeating myself. I hear myself saying this over and over again. Oh my God. This is what could be meant by controlling the opposition. Not what I thought. The opposition would be, opposition to them is Stephen Greer, we want disclosure. Well, if the cabal wants disclosure, but they're playing along with their non-disclosure thing for all these years, but now, okay, it's time. Let's play this right and have demands put on us to disclose, and then we'll control on both sides. And say, they start pouring out the information. And they're going to give us what they want to give us. They're not going to give us everything. And they're going to tell a story with it. And they're going to control that narrative. And it might be that exactly what Nai'Shara said.
Declassification can, or will, cause new laws, rules, regulations, and censorship. And the group of people who will be most affected and attacked will be the starseeds.
You know, it makes me think of a kind of like a metaphor. Let's say you have this island state. You know, it's way back when, and the population of this island, they think that's all that exists in the entire world or universe, and they've got the controllers of that population, and there are some people on that island that know that there are other islands out in the ocean. And that there are advanced civilizations out there. And the controllers of this little island love to have control over their population. And they're actually trading, slave trade, to some of these other, not all, but some of these other island states out there in the ocean, way beyond what the population can see or get to, right? So some of the population is aware that they are out there, and trying to wake everybody up, say, hey, there's a lot of other islands out there with a lot of other civilizations out there. And, you know, we're being rather oppressed here. Maybe we could, you know, get off our island and go somewhere else and live, or invite some of them over to help us deal with our oppressive governing agents on our little island out in the sea. And, those in control here go, no, that's not going to happen. We're not going to let that happen. Well, how do we control this if you're getting a lot of people on the little island demanding in disclosing the facts that the little island state knows about these guys out here? They've got sunken ships and shipwrecks and all this stuff. How do we control this? Well, let's control the opposition, and then let's let it be known that there are other island states out there, and say, I could see one scenario right here. You know, if I was the government of that cabal, now that was my special interest to control, dominate the population, I'd go, well, we don't want help coming in. We don't want our population being helped to wake up. No. So what we'll do is we can just say that, you know, for your own good, now that we know they're out there, and you know that they're out there, we need to put in some policies so that some of you don't be doing shit to provoke war, piss off the bad guys out there, or you're not doing things to alienate the good guys the friendly ETs, and we just got to put some control in, because yes, and they will even have the controlled opposition, the population, but it's a bunch of agents, right? Saying we demand you do something. We can't be bad mouthing the good guys out there. You know, they are our friends, and we might need them to help protect us from the bad guys out there, the pirates. Yeah, yeah, yeah. And so our little government on this little island, in my metaphor, you go, okay, yeah, 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 okay. We will put in some new rules about no talking about the other islands and the islanders out there. It's for your own safety. We will take care of this. But don't be talking about that stuff anymore. Kind of like that.
The governments may or will say that there is a need to censor and control everything that has to do or what is said about extraterrestrials. They may say that censorship is necessary to control all the misinformation people are saying about the extraterrestrials, with this silencing all the star seeds.
The rationale being, they might give in, you know, they're being friendly. Now, our government is saying, well, you know, we know we're censoring everything because that's the only way we can censor the hostile individuals out in our population from talking shit about the ETs and stirring up the rest of the population and getting them all upset and angry at ETs. And we know there's some people that are saying nice things about the ETs, but it's such a big threat of, you know, misinformation and disinformation stirring up the population. And it's such a critical issue, so important, that the easiest way to control all this is just censor everyone. No more talking about ETs, UFOs, ET sightings. Disclosure. The only thing you'll get is official disclosure. And they will probably keep feeding the population what they need, information about ETs. And they will completely control the narrative then, having shut down all the controlled opposition and all the opposition that is people like you and me, starseeds, talking to the ETs. And because a lot of people do communicate that stuff about the ETs. Wow.
Starseeds, as strong as they can be, are a very vulnerable group, and life on Earth is very hard for them. The last thing they need is to be openly persecuted in some kind of witch hunt, simply because they have said that they are starseeds, therefore non-humans. The emotional and mental strain and weight starseeds are subjected to is already very strong, and further organized attacks could finally cause many, if not most of them, to collapse. With this, the Cabal and its governments could be able to neutralize starseeds and all their influence on the general population they want to control.
So that'd be a really big operation, I mean, very important. And carrying a lot of weight that would influence the Cabal's outcome of their particular plans and strategies for planet Earth. If they could shut down the starseeds, those awake beings that know that they were once upon a time coming from other planets and stars, incarnating here to help awaken the people of Earth. Yeah, yeah. So it could be a strategy to shut down the freedom of speech, especially those that are talking about the ETs, the good ones and the bad ones, the regressives and the progressive ETs, and also talking shit about our government of the world and how there's corruption in government and what that's all about and all the details. And the conspiracies and this all that secret society stuff and control and domination manipulation strategies that they use. That's what starseeds do.
The false alien invasion, or simply disclosure, may be a way to get rid of starseeds and the interference they cause for the cabal. The general population may end up organizing against starseeds in another fear reaction mindless rampage, like the one we recently saw because of the little invisible monster. Starseeds are great reality creators, and I don't doubt they can deactivate or prevent all this from happening on their own. A single starseed influences and even guides large groups of people.
Yeah, kind of like what I was saying earlier. Choose your path, take everybody with you, and you're creating that new reality. And the other aspects of beings that are on these other reality systems of some individual is the center of that reality, creating everybody. So we could have, it's like we have bits of our own consciousness in this time track, and this time track, this time track, this time track. And we're on this time track, we're considering this to be our, from this point of view, our primary reality and time track. But we have bits of us here and here and here and here. Likewise, if this is your primary track and reality, and this is mine, I have bits of you over here with me. But you and me are both source anyway, and we are the consciousness that is. So it's really, from a higher perspective, being me, I've got bits of, as source, we have bits of us everywhere. See how deep? It's getting pretty deep, huh? Pretty cool, huh? Yeah. Okay.
And without needing to utter a single word, they can change and steer collective timelines for the better. And that is precisely one of the reasons they have incarnated on Earth.
Yeah, baby!
Starseeds are powerful, but the problem is that governments also know they are. They know this, and they will stop at nothing in order to control, or even eradicate the starseeds. Because those are the ones who are most powerfully and openly working against the cabal's intentions and plans. Starseeds are a powerful opposing force against the cabal. Never underestimate this, as you must never underestimate the cabal and what it is capable of to get away with its evil agendas. Thinking this is not possible may be naive, because some years ago it would be impossible to think that they could pull off such a psychological operation as large and as false as the little evil monster, and the general public simply fell for all the lies. And
right.
Flat out. As Nai'Shara explained here, using the series of movies X-Men, where the mutants are persecuted because of their powers, so can the starseeds be persecuted for their powers, such as being highly awakened and conscious, telepathy, manifestation power, clairvoyance, empathy, strong connection to source, their ability to guide the general population, among so many others. Starseeds do have real superpowers. This hasn't come to pass yet, but we do see this scenario, or variants of this one, as a true future possibility. This hasn't come to pass yet, but we do see this scenario, or variants of this one, as a true future possibility.
I didn't repeat that. It repeated it on its own. But yeah. It's a possibility. There's infinite possible futures, and some of them are more likely than others.
The more people who know about this theory, the less probable it will become.
Exactly what I was saying. we're learning about this theory and understanding and this potential probability possibility, so that you and I can go, no. Instead of it like slipping by, slipping by our awareness, and we accidentally manifest it sort of unconsciously. When you can manifest something unconsciously, or you can manifest the same thing consciously. Or while you're manifesting nothing in particular or this way, you're going do-do-do, you're not really consciously manifesting anything. You will still manifest everything unconsciously. So being more aware of what's the possible unconscious or conscious manifestation possibilities and probabilities, that gives us even more power to go, aha, okay, no, no, yes, yes. Kind of like that. Kind of.
Because it deactivates the cabal's plans. We must anticipate their moves. And if enough people are aware of this possibility, then it most probably will not happen at all.
Yeah.
So, please share it with your fellow starseed friends. Absolutely. And let's not let this happen. Remember, you are the only true creators of your personal and collective reality.
You know, the more I listen to these wonderful people, the more connected I feel to them. Because, like, what they're sharing is what I'm knowing and understanding myself. And I go, yeah, yeah, yeah. They say it better and more eloquently, and they know gazillions more than I do. But some of the things that they share, I am so in tune with, and I actually enjoy breaking it out, breaking it down, and expressing it or sharing it from a position of being a human being, playing as a human. Boots on the ground, old shoes, and sharing with you guys, because I can relate really well with how you're doing and what the hell's going on around here, and I like doing it. So I kind of think that, gee, maybe that's one of my jobs, my mission assignments, so to speak, is to break it out and re-say it. But always use your own discernment and make your own choices and decisions, and, you know, find those sources of information, shuffle through it, cherry pick it, take, oh, I like this, I don't like that, I don't know about it. Always go for that stuff that is most empowering, and always work from the inside out. You're going to get fun and joy out of playing out in the physical world, but what you're doing inside is affecting yourself and everything that you're manifesting subconsciously or unconsciously, including other people in your life. Everyone you love, everyone you hate, is a reflection of the creation ability that you have as a source being. From this point of view. So the work happens in here, kind of like that. And this is from my observation and perception so far and experience. That's what the Taygetans are teaching us. They're wonderful spiritual guides and teachers for me, and hopefully for you too. All right. Wow. Thank you, Swaruu.
Please be strong out there, dear starseeds. And above all, be very wise. Thank you for watching my video, and for liking and subscribing for more. I appreciate it a lot. With much love. Your friend, Mari Swaruu.
Wow. That was really, really good for me. It was as good for you. Mari, thank you so, so much. That helped a lot. I kind of needed that, like, as a personal message to me, and others, I'm sure, are getting a very personal message, like she's talking to them specifically. That's what it feels like for me. Wow, thank you so, so much. And Nai'Shara, thank you for your brilliant analysis and information on the subject. I didn't see that one. That's fucking great. So keep up the good work, you Taygetan Pleiadian ETs, you. We really appreciate it. I do, and I know so many others do as well. Okay, thanks for watching. If you like my breakouts and commentaries, please put a comment below. It kind of encourages me, because sometimes I get all fucked up and go, oh shit, this is fucked up, man. But your words of encouragement and letting me know that you get something out of it helps inspire me to continue doing these kinds of things too. And I think it is important as well. Okay. And thank you all for watching. I really, really appreciate it. And do your thing, man. Talk to you later. Okay. Bye-bye.